the life, I'm going to be living above my means. And for some of us, we've never been able to discipline ourselves enough, Sister Nicole, to say no to the things that catch our attention. So we've got to assess our damage. Touch your neighbor and say, you got to assess your damage. Some of us have not built up good walls of relationship and communication. And so you've got to assess the damage that's been done to your relationship because of the neglect that you have placed in your relationship. I'm talking about your personal relationship. I'm talking about your spiritual relationship. I don't care what kind of relationship it is. If you have not cultivated, if you've not taken care of your relationship, there's going to be trouble. Walls are going to be destroyed. And you've got to assess the damage. Lord, I know this is tough in the first of the year.
That's all right.
Can you tell it's all good?
It's all good.
So the first thing that Nehemiah did, and the first thing you got to do, you got to assess the damage. He went out and he began to look around. He said, by night, I went out through the valley gate. But look, I'm going to tell you that you've got to assess the damage. But in assessing the damage, you've got to go to some gates and some places that you've been before. Thank you, Jesus. You see, the gates were places where courts of justice were held. This is where business was conducted. At the gates, proclamations were made. At the gates, criminals were punished. Can I suggest to you this morning that in assessing the damage, sometimes you got to revisit your gates. Help me, Holy Ghost. You've got to do what Nehemiah did. The Bible says that by night he went through the valley gate. I'm going to tell you that the valley gate represents humility. And there are some of us that are going to have to revisit the valley gate and see if our walls are broken down because we have not shown a spirit of humility. We've not been willing to take the low places. We've not been willing to take down. And so if we're going to assess the damage, we've got to re-inspect the gates. Help me, Lord Jesus. He said, I went through to the jackal well. Somebody say, the jackal well. That represents a serpent place, a place of deceit, a place of cheating, a place of misleading. It means that for some of us, in assessing the damage, we've got to check out and see whether we've been deceitful, whether we've been lying, whether we've been cheating, whether we've been hypocritical. So we've got to revisit the gates because it's at the gates where punishment is shown out upon us. He said, not only did I go to the jackal well, but I went to the dung gate. The dung gate represents gates of deterioration and dirt and filth. So we've got to visit that place where maybe the wall was broken down because of our filth, because of our junk, because of our junkiness, because of our junky attitudes or our junky thoughts. But we've got to revisit the gate, the dung gate in our eyes. Somebody say amen. He said, I did all of this while I was examining the walls. I was assessing the damage. So I went on a little tour in my life. And I tell somebody, God wants you to take a little tour of your life. He wants you to go back and to begin to assess something because you can't move forward. Help me, Holy Ghost. Until we've done this, ooh, I got to hasten. He says, but then I went on down to where with the gates that had been broken down, destroyed by fire. He said, then I moved toward the fountain gate. I want you to know the fountain gate represents the infilling of the Holy Spirit. We need to visit the fountain gate and see if there's been a fresh infilling of the Holy Spirit. When's the last time you had a fresh infilling of the Holy Spirit? For some of us, that first filling when we were baptized in the Holy Ghost has been the only time that we have been filled with the Spirit. But I want you to know that you need fresh infillings. And so he said, I had to go by the fountain gate on my way to the King's Pool. Glory to God. For see, once you stop by the fountain gate, then you're ready to go to the upper room. That's what the King's Pool represents, that higher place, that higher calling that God is speaking to us about. And so, beloved, if you want to rebuild the walls, you've got to revisit the gates. Glory to God. You've got to stop by the pools. You've got to stop by some places that you might have passed up on the way. You sometimes have to go back, do some first works over. You got to go back, check out some things that were left undone. You got to see what the real damage is. Because after you assess the damage, then you damage and begin the process. Somebody say, assess the damage, then begin the process. Glory to God. Nehemiah says that after I had done all of this assessing, then I was ready to go back. Then I re-entered through the valley gate. I understood that after I had done all of this, I had to go back into my spirit of humility and admit that maybe there were some things that I was responsible for. Maybe there's something I could have done a little bit differently. So I re-entered through the valley gate. I want to tell somebody that God is saying, maybe you've got to go back